Welcome to Around the Dog World today as we celebrate 2015 and sink our teeth into 2016. Welcome to Around the Dog World after the quietest month on the dog show calendar. But not to worry, we've got plenty in store to satisfy your dog show hunger. First of all, we'll take a look at some dogs that deserve a mention for their exploits in 2015 before we take a look at some highlights of Crufts and the Poskers Award Ceremony 2015. And then we'll step into the new year with coverage of Manchester Championship Dog Show 2016, and all wrapped up with some clips of us making fools of ourselves for your entertainment. Now, on last month's programme at Stoke Rochford Hall, Di and Andrew spent their time talking about 2015's top dogs, but unfortunately, some dogs, despite having sensational years, missed out. So let's go and find out some more about the best of the rest.
Third place in the pastoral group is the Pyrenean Mountain Dog, Cody, champion Charibel Simply Special at Chisana. Seen it winning, I think, another couple of groups this year, Di.
And nice to see, because 20 years ago, 30 years maybe, there were wonderful Pyrenees. I've been slightly disappointed by the breed of late, always one or two good ones, but nothing that stood away to me. That is a quality Pyrenean.
And in third place in the hen group is the daughter of a dog we've spoken a lot about in the past. Jilly, champion sole trader Peekaboo, was top dog 2012. Her daughter, Annie Mack, has been following in her footsteps this year, Andrew.
Yeah, little bit like Laser Minnelli, really, isn't it?
Now, is he old enough to know her mother was Judy Garland?
His grandparents will have told him who Judy Garland is, for heaven's sake. When you've had a legendary mother, It's a tough act to follow. If we hadn't seen Jilly, then we would probably be saying what a wonderful petite bitch this is. But you know, you do tend to make comparisons. And yeah, she's a beautiful bitch, but she's not her mother.
I love this bitch. I think she would have done more had she not been Judy Garland's daughter.
And third top terrier, 2015, was Martha, the Norfolk Terrier, Kinsridge top tip.
Yeah. She got her second CC under me. She was in the junior class, I think, just out of puppy. And she's a very, very typey bitch. Fabulous attitude. And, you know, Di Jenkins is one of those breeders. She just carries on breeding consistently typical, excellent dogs.
But Di, there was a fortnight in the middle of the year that will be forever memorable for Di.
Well, focused on her, weren't they? I think it was Johan, Jocelyn,
Southern Counties,
and, well, just fell in love. And then at...
Three Counties.
Yeah. The bitch looked gorgeous again. Exactly as Andrew says. She just, here I am, look at me, I'm pretty special. She is.
We move on to third in the utility group. This is champion Red Witch, Will I Am. He's had a quiet second half of the year, but over the first 6 months, racked up a best in show as well as a few group wins.
Yes. You know, when puppies come out and knock our eye out and win everything in sight, like Will I Am, we can't expect them to maintain that forever. They use all their youth and enthusiasm through the puppy and junior classes. Will I Am now is a stately gentleman. He is siring the next generation of champions.
Another consistent breed winner, Andrew, third place in the Gundog, is a Cocker Spaniel. Possibly the most consistent breed winner we've got on the list of top dogs today. But so far hasn't done any great amount more in the group. Why is that?
How many CCs has he won?
I think something like 19 in the year.
Yeah. Well, you'll have to ask the group judges why he's not done more. I had him at Midland Counties in what I considered to be a very, very strong gun dog group. And I just loved his cockeriness. You know, he's compact. He's got big ribs, you know, he's got a proper Cocker Spaniel head and expression, the correct top line, the correct croup and tail set, and, you know, the merry little cocker. His little tail never stops. I share your surprise.
And we move to bronze medal position in the working group, and that is Bernese Mountain Dog. We watched it winning the group at Darlington.
We did.
Meadow Park Vertigo.
Yes. Well deserved, I thought.
And another young dog, Andrew, we'll hopefully see more of in the future.
Yeah, he won the breed under me at Three Counties in June. I was very impressed with him. Type, substance, excellent mover, holds his outline at all times.
Not one that's going to features in the top three in the group, but the biggest win for a terrier this year was in March. Scottish terrier, all the way from America, having bred in Russia, titles all over the world, went into Best in Show under Ronnie Irving and stole more than his heart.
The Scotty is an exceptional Scotty, no question about it. I think she deserved to win.
And we got another chance to see her at Windsor this year, Di. She came back to win her UK title.
And great for the ringside to see dogs of that calibre.
It certainly was.
Yes, it's super.
Knopper, the Scotty's Best in Show win at Crafts 2015, was just the tip of the iceberg of a superb Crafts. And with 2016 show just round the corner, it's got to go some way to measure up. Red hot competition in the breed rings, thrilling groups, all wrapped up with Ronnie Irving's Best in Show lineup. Let's remind ourselves of the whole weekend. Best of breed in hand, and there it is.
That's great.
Champion Roper Main Ice Maiden, Best of Breed at Crufts 2015.
Yeah, well, that's lovely, and I mean, there is the bitch that you've got to watch in the group.
He's the sweetest, kindest person you could ever wish to meet. He's a true flat coat.
Very impressive show dog, lovely on the go around. There's not a lot of room around this ringside, actually.
So there certainly isn't.
I mean, all these handlers are getting very tense now because, yes, he's won the class. Yeah.
You've won seven groups before with him, but the eighth at Croft.
I know. It's just incredible, isn't it? Just incredible.
A massive congratulations again, and we'll see you in the Best in Show at Crufts on Sunday.
How amazing is that, just to be there, just to be part of that experience on Sunday? It's like, I just can't, it hasn't sunk in.
No group win is ever automatic. That was the dog he liked best, so point and put it up.
And, I mean, the quality in this class is something to behold.
Well, I haven't seen an open dog class in wires like this for 30 years, maybe.
Today was supposed to be her last show with me. So today has just been amazing. This whole last month has been really a dream come true.
I don't think anyone could criticize him for putting the Scotty over the wire. I mean, they're two great dogs.
And your wife was saying you're his playmate.
Yeah, I am. I am his. He probably thinks that I'm his brother. I think.
But surely you can take that.
Absolutely. I'm happy to be his ragdoll.
When you get that gorgeous, exquisite saluki expression, there's nothing quite like it.
Mom's standard.
Which will we see in the toy group later? There we are.
It goes to the dog, and you know, traditionally, you would give the best of breed card to the judge who has given in, for want of a better word.
I knew that I had a beautiful dog going into the ring with, but, you know, to win the group at Crufts has never, ever been in my dreams.
It was a phenomenal group, and I thought Zena judged it extremely well. Beautiful bitch top in a beautiful group. It's so unusual to get a Maltese that moves that freely, has that top line and that carriage. Beautiful pigment, wonderful expression. It's another great group.
Rebecca and Knopper, how are you feeling?
I'm still in shock, just like yesterday. It's no different.
What a way to sign off.
Well, yeah, and I'm going to be a wreck when she finally goes home. I will be in tears. I don't know if I'll ever have a dog like this again.
She's got a classic head. She's got a good body. She's not overdone in any way. She's got good depth. She moved well. And you can see she's still in there. Yeah. She's showing her head off, sitting there, even without her handler.
And the Scottish connection made no difference?
Absolutely none whatsoever, no. None at all. Yeah.
The photographers will hate Ronnie, of course, two black dogs. Two black dogs. Worst things in the world to photograph. But, you know, great Scotty.
And he talked about that exquisite head.
Yeah, I mean, you know, she looks at you right.
Before the break, we watched highlights of a truly memorable Crufts 2015, but don't forget, the week was all kicked off with another cracking event. The Poskers Awards ceremony celebrated the successful, the hardworking, and even the unrecognised in every part of the dog game. Do you remember the winners? No? Well, we can help. Let's take a look.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Poskers 2015.
And the winner is... Hub.
And the winner is Colin Woodward.
Marjorie Dickinson. Simon Parsons.
John Thurwell.
Middlebury and Waterbeck.
Luton Canine Association.
Welsh Kennel Club.
And the winner is Tegan Hart Jones. Judith.
And the winner is Gernot.
And the winner is Frank Kane.
Yes, very good, Mr. Kane, yes. Yes, it's a combination of breed type and movement, yes. Yes. I will never win again.
A bit of a no-brainer for last year and a truly remarkable, outstanding achievement. The winner this year is the Afterglow team of Mike and Jason.
I think Sarah said before that success, I think, is never about me or I, it's always about us and we. And the success of Afterglow over the years has always been a team effort, and I'd just like to say thank you very much. It's been an honour. Thank you very much.
She is British Dogs.
Well, an icon, absolute icon.
To be 90, still be so keen when you go there, she takes you out to show her new puppy, she's still got a sparkle in her eye.
She makes you laugh.
And I can't think of anybody more deserving this award than Marion Spavin.
I've loved my life in the dog world and met some lovely people.
Bless you all.
The Poskers on the eve of Crufts this year again will celebrate breeders, judges, stewards and shows for their contribution to the sport, and will mark a high point as some people get called to the stage to collect their Poskers award. However, everyone has a few memorable moments from last year. There were, of course, so many to pick from. So let's find out from our experts and a few of last year's big winners about their highlights of 2015. But first, we'll start here. Simon, at the Poskers Awards last year, you took home Journalist of the Year. That must have been one of your highlights.
Yeah, it was a shock, I can tell you that. But it was a proud moment. And I think what it brought home to me was how all of us who try and write something about dogs or any other subject each week depend on the people who provide you with inspiration, provide you with copy and material. And I think in the dog world, we're very lucky that way. You know, dog people tend not to be short of opinions. That comes in very handy when you try to write a couple of columns, you know, every single week. Yeah.
Can you both pick some highlights for us, Andrew?
Yeah, well, you know what my highlight is of 2015. You teased me about it often enough.
But however, of ours, Andrew. Yeah. Simon and I thought the whole...
This is true. You're extremely magnanimous about my judging of all seven groups and best in show.
Just honest.
One of the moments that I'll never forget last year was at Crufts, watching Lynn Snow sort out open dog in wire fox terriers, because that was incredible. It was a class like we haven't seen in 20 years. There were fabulous dogs from all around the world. And Lynn, he just got in there, got on with it, and judged him like a proper dog, man.
King takes first place in open dog.
Hiroshi comes out second with a dog from Japan. Oliver's third. It's no disgrace in that competition.
How many best in show winners and how many best in shows in total in that one ring on that one day? It was incredible.
Yeah, I mean, I can't imagine what those dogs have won between them. And, you know, he ended up with King, the wire that we've discussed before, that we both have a high regard for.
Yes, absolutely.
And it was a pleasure to... I was proud of Lynn. I was proud he's Welsh.
There was a great atmosphere by that ring.
Well, if you could get near it.
Yeah, five deep.
And what about another highlight from 2015?
I think for me it wasn't so much any one specific show or anything like that, but what did encourage me was that there were so many younger generation of breeders, owners, handlers were doing so well in so many different breeds. I think it started off at Crufts where young Ryan Ross, I think, won a group place with his English Toy Terrier and made such a wonderful impression through his enthusiasm and dignity as well at the same time as this great winner. I think the youngest person ever to win so well. And then subsequently, many of the top dogs were handled by people in their teens, 20s or early 30s, which is what we need for the continuation of our hobby. I think that this year it really encouraged me that we've got so many people who I think are going to take the dog world and the dogs onto hopefully a bright future.
Di, for you, any highlights?
Am I allowed to be a little bit sentimental? Because I have two. I wasn't even at Welks, but my friend Ken Sinclair gave Best in Show to a young man called
Andy Morris
with a Shar Pei. Now, we've watched this fellow with two very good Shar Peis. He used to show Dobermans, and he had an accident at work and lost his arm. So he and his wife looked for a breed that they liked nearly as much. How that man handles those Shar Peis so well, how he gets the front so true. The thought of him taking a Best in Show victory meant a great deal to me. What a feel-good story, isn't it? And the other, we all have special puppies. We all see a puppy and think, oh, this is wonderful. I was like it with Andrew's Ada. Mm-hmm. His beagle puppy to me was the best thing. A couple of years ago, Carl saw at Redwich Kennels an Akita puppy called Will I Am that he absolutely fell for. As you know, I lost Carl last year. But at Manchester, one of our favourite shows, Dave Killerly showed Will I Am under Tom Mather, judge we respected, and he got the nod for Best in Show.
The Akita!
David ran across the ring to me and kissed me and said, that one's for Carl, Di. My moment of the year.
Understandable. Mm.
As we said, there were so many highlights of 2015, so after the break, we'll continue reminiscing. But to get you there, here's a look at some footage that never made the edit, and for good reason.
God, he's scrubbed up nicely for the occasion, hasn't he?
There's a compliment in there somewhere.
The toy group is going on behind us, Simon, indeed. And there's a familiar face missing, isn't there?
Yes, it was... Sorry, it's starting again.
Andrew, won by a boohund. Good, love it. That was quick.
Ask the question again.
Yeah. Whoa! I didn't touch it. One of them, Andrew, was a dual group show, National Working Pastoral Breeds, won by a boohund.
Yeah, and I think I'm right in saying this is the very first time.
Excuse me, can I just say before I go, know who I am, but I know who you are, and it's lovely to see you.
Yeah. Oh, that's very kind, thank you very much.
Okay.
Done.
Lilla.
Is that right?
No!
Nope.
Welcome back to Around the Dog World. Now we've got to continue where we left off with some significant moments from 2015. This one is with Juicy the Pointer, top gun dog and third top dog all breeds. Her handler, Sam Dyer, spoke to us at LKA.
Can you pick out a moment of the year as your favourite?
Definitely Southern Counties, yeah. Best in show, yeah.
Now, of course, there is a reserve, a best in show in the reserve, but could the other stay in the ring afterwards, please? There's a sash for you. And it is the Pointer. The Pointer is best in show, Southern Counties 2015. Is the Pointer number 662 with a Saluki.
This bitch is gonna go all the way one day. I didn't know that it was. I didn't know it was me who's gonna do it. To see a dog in your own breed, which is has so many attributes, it makes me warm. The only problem with this bitch is that they isn't mine.
It's just phenomenal, you know, when you hear them talking about her and, you know, Sigurd being his own breed as well, it's even better. Never would I ever have thought from when she was 6 weeks old that she'd be a best in show winner.
I remembered another one.
Go on then, see if I agree.
This depends on whether or not you can get out of the breed, of course. Our pup of the year.
Labrador.
Oh, Andrew, that was one of my favourite days last year.
The gorgeous Labrador.
Matt and Exodus.
Yep. Yeah.
And your winner?
I think he's one that, if he gets out of the breed.
I've never known so much good feeling towards a judge as when Jean found it in the Pup of the Year.
Jean Lunning can judge dogs.
Yes, yep.
She's old school, she gets on with it, she knows what she's doing.
Yep.
My favourite was probably Best in Show at Blackpool. It was mine and Hector's first Best in Show, and to win into such an astounding judge breeder, like world-class handler, and to comment on my handling was just phenomenal.
And ladies and gentlemen, give them some encouragement. The Rubio, the Pointer, the Saluki, the Cardigan Welsh Corgi, the Australian, the Tibetan Spaniel, the Papillon, and Best in Show at Blackpool 2015. The Rubio,
I mean, a beautiful type dog, wonderful size, and his construction's exemplary, and when he moves, he's got a lightness on his... I mean, for a nice, big, solid dog to have such light movement, I think he's a really, really beautiful dog, and of course, he was well handled and beautifully put down as well.
Andrew, you spoke briefly about Midland Counties. What was the anticipation like for that weekend?
Well, to be honest, having got over the original excitement when the invitation arrived years ago from Rod Price, and then I was thrilled because it was something I'd always dreamed of doing and never actually thought that I would do. And then I forgot about it, to be honest, until just a couple of days before I was getting packed for Midland Counties. And then I thought, oh, God, I'm doing all the groups in Best in Show. And then I started to get all excited and kid on Christmas morning and, as you know, loved every second of it.
But you have the Pointer, the Afghan Hound, the St. Bernard, the Bearded Collie, the Kiesel, the Irish Terrier, and the Longcoat Chihuahua.
Well, Andrew, littlest dog, biggest ring, and stole your heart.
I'm going to have to do this without crying. She's going to start me off in a minute.
Both of you?
I mean,
7 group winners, I could have given any of them Best in Show. I mean, I loved them all, really.
We watched Anne Ingram, who we both respect.
Well, Anne Ingram was, you know, she did it a couple of years before me, all groups and Best in Show at Midland Counties. I said to Di at the time, this is going to be an impossible act to follow. But anyhow, I did my best.
You made an extremely good job of it. We were impressed, Andrew. I enjoyed your performance as much as I enjoyed Anne's. Now, do you want a better compliment than that?
No. I'm speechless.
Andrew's speechless. Bet you weren't expecting that either. Anyway, we usually focus on the best of the dogs and the sport, but let's set those aside for now and take a look at the mistakes and mishaps that should never make it to air.
Will you cut it if it's crap?
No, I'm going to put it all on the...
Simon, you can't.
I don't know, like Alice Cooper, do I?
Yeah. Shuffle
I
want
to do your reminder.
A little slip up for Handler, but sure-footed beagle.
So hopefully we'll see lots more of her throughout the year. Damn it, damn it, damn it.
Did you just wipe my mud
off? Sorry, Juice. In a few minutes, it's Val Bloor, isn't it?
No, I'm not Val Bloor. I don't even look like her.
And that's everything.
No, I'm sweaty now.
Yeah. Lovely. Was the mic closed?
No.
Blooper reel.
The hands on all of these prizes. Something's just fallen on me.
6969.
Welcome to Stoneleigh Park as we tumble into the autumn shows. This weekend, we'll watch...
You just looked funny, sorry.
Very unprofessional. Welcome to Stoneleigh Park as we tumble in...
I got the giggles. After a consistent start...
It's a conspiracy.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for staying behind to see the finals. We've got through it all. Only 10 past 6, that's not bad going. We wish you a safe journey home. We hope you enjoyed.
And now we turn our attention firmly to 2016, and we have to start at the very first championship show. And to help us, we welcome Simon Parsons. Very nice to see you, Simon. Now, the first championship show was Boston, and we started as we finished.
Yes.
Travis the Papillon grabbing the headlines again.
Yes, so that's his second all-breed Best in Show win of his career. The first one came last year at the East of England show, and the second one at the very same venue at Peterborough. So I think he might be quite happy to go back there a few times.
Yes.
So he had a great career in the group rings last year and ended up at Top Dog All Breeds.
Yeah.
And who knows, perhaps he might make a repeat performance. Not many dogs have done it twice, so interesting to see what transpires this year.
Yeah, they really enjoyed their year last year. They said they want to keep him out some more. And in a competitive toy group, it's hard going to win at that level.
It certainly is. It's always one of the strongest groups at the British shows. So, in fact, last year, number one and number two, both were toy dogs.
And the second and most recent show was Manchester, a trip to Bingley Hall, where on Sunday night, the 7 group winners would step into the Best in Show ring under the chairman of the Portuguese Kennel Club, Carla Molinari. But first, let's see who makes up for Best in Show.
First out is the Bedlington Terrier, followed by the Border, Dandy Dinmont, the Wire Fox Terrier, Irish Terrier, Kerry Blue Terrier, the Soft Coated Wheat, the West Highland White, the Skye Terrier. We have our first group winner, and it's the Border Terrier. Big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Winner of the Terrier Group, the Border Terrier. Group 2, the Soft Coated Wheat Terrier. Group 3, the Skye Terrier. Group 4, the Irish Terrier. That's the Afghan Hound. That's the Griffon Monty Amputee. The Beagle is the Long-haired Dachshund. The Green Wirehead Dachshund. The Irish Wolfhound. The Norwegian Elkhound. The Rhodesian Ridgeback. The Saluki. The Rhodesian Ridgeback. Group 2, the Bichon Frise, the Cavalier King Charles Spaniel, the Long Coat Chihuahua, the Japanese Chin, the Pavillon, and the Pomeranian. Our toy group winner is the Papillon, followed by the Bichon Frise, followed by the Cavalier King Charles Spaniel, and the Japanese Chin. Followed by the Boston Terrier, Bulldog, the Shiba Inu, the Miniature Schnauzer, and the last Lhasa. Group 1 goes to the Bulldog. Followed by the Akita. Group 3, the Miniature Schnauzer, and in Group 4, the Japanese Shiba Inu. First out is the Alaska Malamute, the Creator Barbara, the Boxer, the Doberman, Newfoundland, Portuguese Water Dog, the Rottweiler, and the Bull Mastiff. It's the Newfoundland. Followed by the Alaska Malamute, the Bull Mastiff, and the Rottweiler. First out, we have the Australian Shepherd, followed by the Painted Collie, the Border Collie, the Briards, the Norwegian Bluehound, the Siberian Sheepdog, the Samoyed, and the Shetland Sheepdog. The Briards! Followed by the Australian Shepherd, the Caribbean Mountain Dog, and the Shetland Sheepdog. Working group, judged by Mr. Ben Englund, and
The winner was
Best in Show at Manchester 2016. That looked like an amazing win for you.
Oh, excellent. Brilliant win.
Tell us a little bit about Tyler.
Tyler's nearly three. He's three in March, and this is his third Best in Show, and he's had a reserve Best in Show as well, so over the moon with him.
And it's absolutely lovely to see a bulldog absolutely racing around that ring. I mean, he looked fresh as a daisy.
Yeah, he is. He's too playful.
And how many CCs has he got now?
25.
And his ninth group win, was it, the other night?
Ninth group win. 25 CCs, about 13, 14 reserve CCs.
And do you think you could have ever achieved sort of this much with him?
No, because I wasn't going to keep him as a puppy.
And who persuaded you to?
Well, I just took him out showing, and obviously first time he went out, it was 6 months and one day, he picks a reserve CC up. So.
And he's been flying since then?
Well, no, after that, he never got out for about four or five shows. Then all of a sudden, he just went, gone for it, really.
And what does it mean winning under a Portuguese judge, Carlo Molinari?
Over the moon.
Well, congratulations. Well done. We hope to see you more this year.
I hope so, too. And more Best in Shows.
So, as you heard, this judge of these groups, our 7 group finalists, are all that's the winner of the Hell Pub Group, the Passenger, number 142. Also on day one, we have the Terrier Pub Group. And the winner was the White West Highland White Terrier, number 2002. That's the winner of the Terrier Pub Group, the West Highland White Terrier, number 2002. Utility Pub Group. And the winner was the Lhasa Apso, number 4499. That's the winner of the Utility Pub Group, the Lhasa Apso, number 4499. Also on day two, we have the Touring Pub Group. And the winner was the Japanese Chief, number 2939. That's the winner of the Touring Pub Group, the Japanese Chief, number 2939. On day three, we have the Carlton Pub Group. And the winner was the Pyrenean Mountain Dog, number 6874. That's the winner of the Pastoral Group, Puppy Group, the Pyrenean Mountain Dog. So on day three, we have
So, Simon, there we have it. Another dog, heavily featured in 2015. Starts his 2016 rather well. Yes. Tyler the Bulldog.
Yes, he had a remarkable year last year, winning the popular contest of champions earlier on in the year. And then it all suddenly came right for him later in the season, and he won best in show at two shows and reserve best in show at a third, all within the space of just 2 weeks.
Wow.
And I think that this win probably at Manchester would be particularly pleasing for the owners Paul and Hayley Seal, because as it happened last year when he had his big run of success, it happened to be when they were off on holiday sunning themselves. So a friend of theirs, Dave Salkell, took him in and won best in show. Anyway, this time Paul, who usually handles him, was back home, so he got the glory on this occasion.
And that leaves us just to look at Crafts 2016. It's just round the corner.
Yes.
What are you looking forward to this year?
Oh, I just look forward to the whole thing. I've been going to the show since I think it was 1969, and only missed 1 year, which was 1970. So Crafts is something, you know, I'm passionate about every year, and wouldn't miss it for the world. I think we all find the exciting thing is just simply looking at the dogs. Each year nowadays you get a number of dogs, I think it's over 3,000 this year, from overseas. A lot of them you won't have seen before, so it's a wonderful opportunity to compare the best of the whole world.
Just looking at last year, for instance, were there only two British dogs that made it through to the best in show?
Exactly, yeah. And one of those, I think, was bred overseas.
Yeah,
wasn't
it? One in France, yeah.
Yes.
And finally, we wrap up the Crufts weekend with a familiar face to these cameras, Derek Smith in the Best in Showing.
Yes.
I think any serious dog person is looking forward to watching Derek at Best in Showing.
Yes. I'm sure he will judge with great style and dignity as always, and a lifetime background in the sports.
Derek is judging Best in Show, yes, and I'm looking forward to that, because there's no doubt in my mind that there'll be seven dogs and the best one will win. Simple as.
I think whoever wins under him will be very proud to have done so.
Yeah.
In fact, he is such an outstanding judge that for the first time in 20 years, Di Johnson is actually going to Crufts to watch him.
That is the reason.
And that is true.
It's been publicised now. You have a quiet weekend.
Well, can't get out of it.
Funnily enough, it was Carl, when Derek had the invitation and couldn't wait to tell us he'd have the green envelope, Carl was the first thing Carl said, and it meant a lot to Derek and still does. Well, we'll be there, Derek. Because he's our friend.
There you are.
He'll make a good job of it.
Yeah, he will.
He's a real dog man.
So we've covered 2015 quite extensively. 2016, beyond Crafts, is there anything you're anticipating most?
Yeah. One thing I'm personally looking forward to, courtesy of Miss Thimble here, is that the Jack Russell Terrier is actually being shown at Kennel Club shows for the first time. The Parson Russell Terrier, the slightly taller variety, has been shown for, I think, more than 20 years now. But the Kennel Club has just decided to recognise the Jack Russell Terrier. So at National Terrier Show, a few weeks after Crufts, we will see them in the show ring for the first time.
and a hotly anticipated first breed entry.
Yes, it will indeed. Again, it's strangely enough, as a traditional British breed, at long last it's achieving its rightful place in the British show scene. And they're, you know, such enchanting little dogs that I'm sure they will catch on among show people very quickly.
Well, thank you very much, Simon. Thank you, Thimble. And thank you very much for watching. Join us again next month on Around the Dog World, where we watch the Oscars Award Ceremony and, of course, Crufts 2016.